I have been in the anti-pay-to-win community for a while now, and every time after duplicating money, you have to distribute it. This is either by auction house or by paying everyone. That is the main way. But what if you had a client to do that for you? It could be paying people while you're duplicating money. This would make destroying the economy so much more effective and so much more destructive at the end. To start off, we need to create the bare bones of the client. Luckily, there's already a template mod generated online. Now I can start working on the client. Normally, I would have to slash pay each person individually. Pay and then a player, so let's do that, 10. And then we can do the next person. Down, let's do this one, 10. And we'll do one more. Let's do that one. There we go. Yeah, pay 3 people $10. That did take a while, even in 2x speed. So making a client would be significantly better. Well, my goal is for the client to get everyone online as well as see how much money we have. And then after that, it'll divide it evenly to pay everyone equally. Now for the auction house, we'll have it do /AA and it'll pull this up. Some auction houses just have items from the first to the last. So we'll just pick that first one, then that first one again for confirmation. Now, if we want to stop it or pause the mod, we need a command for that too. I think we should just add one more thing. And I think the user should be able to pick how many ticks the client waits until the next command is ran or until it buys the next item. A anti-pay-to-win distributing mod. So it distributes money on pay-to-win servers. I have 4 different commands: pay all, buy out, auction house, stop what it's doing, and then change the tick. So right now on lifesteal, I have a balance of $25,000. Pay all, and how much do I have? Let's just do 1,000. It should be every 20 ticks. So give it a sec. I played $4, and then $4, invalid argument. Couldn't find player name. Okay, I was getting errors. Just stop what you're doing. It'll stop it entirely. Sick, you can see that it stopped. Buyout auction house, there we go. Okay, empty. Shit. So I need to add 2 things. One of them is that it has to check whether the player is in that server. That's for the payoff. And then for the auction house, right now it's only clicking this first slot in the auction house. But we want it to click somewhere else. So we have to tell the client, hey, we want to click somewhere else. So if I'm going to click here, we have to tell the client, hey, I want to click here. Then it's like, all right, cool. When you run that command, it'll then click there. And then we'll do that same thing with confirm purchase. We have to have 2 variables, first position, second position. I'll copy that. But if we do /A, here's how it works. So all of these have different numbers. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. So then 9, 10, 11. We want to pick on 11. So we can do slash that 11 for that first position. And if we do /age and click on it, once it clicks on it, we need to find the screen position. So there's 9 across, so that'd be 9, 18, 27. This time we can also count 27, 28, 29, 30, 31 minus 1 equals to 30. This 30. So if we go here, set up position, click on enter, it now sets up position. So we can now do slash buy out auction house and click on enter. It should click and then click trying to buy it. The next version needs to open up the auction house after it buys something so that it opens it up and then instantly goes into buying more stuff, and that's a continuous loop. Now if we run the same thing, 11:30, now we run buy auction, it'll click on it, click on buy, and then continuously reopen it until something comes up that we need to buy. Now after buy something, will it reopen again? That's what I want to watch and see. I don't know if it works or not. After about 30 minutes, I kind of just gave up. The next thing I'll work on is paying everyone. While it's going to the name, if there's something other than a letter or a number, it'll skip over it. 1,000. So it needs to be actual people in the server. Paid. Wait. So it's paying people correctly. If it doesn't have anything other than a character or a number, it just skips through it. The next thing I'm gonna fix is the auction house. If it continuously tries to buy something and you don't have enough money, it's not gonna stop. After a certain amount of times trying to purchase something, it'll just automatically stop trying to purchase it so that you can dupe more. Another one is that if your inventory is full, it'll also stop so that you can distribute those items and then run it again, buying out more of the auction house to distribute those items to the economy as well. You know, we need to run buy out auction house, and then it'll try and buy it. False, that's one. That'll be two. That'll be three. And then the next one, it won't do it anymore. Just like that, it'll completely stop it. And then if our inventory is also full, it won't do it either. So let me fill up my inventory real quick. Cool, now that our inventory is full, if we run slash buy out auction house, it won't run it. Just like that, it won't run it. But if I go out, double click this, and then run it, it'll try and purchase it. You see? So after done making that, I promoted it inside of a few Discord in the community distributing mod. It is for 1.version 1.4. That is currently the latest version as of recording that video. And then later on, someone was like, hey, shamelessly plugging, they already made one. I didn't know that. I misset some stuff, so let me redo that. Mine cannot blacklist players, but his can. Mine can buy out the auction house, his can't. Alright, I forgot to record what I was gonna do, so let me record what I did do. So now mine has three new commands. Ignore, where you can add players to ignore. Ignored players, where you can see what players you can ignore. And teleport to players. It will then start sending teleport requests to different players on the server. So now those commands are now added. So I can do slash ignore capital I. Let's just do Sapphire, my YouTube name. That now we can do ignored players, and when we click on that, it adds Sapphire. So let's add Sapphire with a 3. Let's do that same thing, it adds it to the list. So we can add different things, and it'll just continue adding to the ignored list. Then when we do slash teleport to players, it'll go through everyone selling teleport requests except the players inside of that ignored list. So we click on enter, sent teleport sent request, sent. And you can see it's trying to send crest. Now I can just stop it like that. Teleporting in one. Teleporting. You mother. Oh shit. Okay, well damn. That's probably all I'm gonna update for this video. But I'm gonna show you how to get it though. I'm probably doing a little more than how to get it. But here's the GitHub. Mine is just SPR3. And then that is the mod. I'll just throw it in the description as well. But if you want to read the code, click on this part, and then wait, pay everyone, and then payeveryone.java, and then here is all of the code. You can click on releases, click on here, and then click on download the jar, and then throw it into your mods folder. And then to get all of the information again about it, you'll go down here, and it'll give you all the information I just talked about, with the numbers, the ID of the panel, and all the commands. If you did enjoy the video, like and subscribe, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.